Hello there. Today we're going to be talking about how to download weather data for hundreds or thousands of locations using the Visual Crossing weather data scheduling feature. This feature allows you to set up a query and then have the Visual Crossing servers run that data every single day at the same time, and then you download that data whenever you need it and integrate it into other tools such as a spreadsheet application like Excel or Google Sheets, or maybe a database or an application. So here we are on the Visual Crossing homepage. I'm going to click on the Query Builder, and if you saw one of our previous videos, you'll know that the Query Builder is used for the viewing weather data, building weather API queries, also downloading weather data, and finally setting up scheduled data sets such as the ones we're going to do today. We've got London and the next 15 days weather forecast here, but we'd like to set up and import multiple locations. I'm going to click on the import locations link. This allows me to import the locations from a file which I've already pre-created in Excel and saved as a CSV file. So I'm going to choose that file, my example locations file, and this location can be one or more columns that form the address or the latitude and longitude. So I can click here and then work through the wizard that allows the system to understand how the address is created, or the partial address. And in this case, the city name and country is enough information for the system to know the locations we're discussing. I click through, it imports the locations. And now when I click on the view data here, you can see that I have my locations, London, Tokyo, Washington, Paris, and Berlin, all available here. And I can switch between them and see the forecast. Now for my scheduled weather data set, I want to look at the last 7 days. So I'm going to change this date range from next 15 days to the last 7 days. Here we go. And these dynamic date queries, as we discuss, are perfect for the scheduled queries because they will allow you to update the data for the last 7 days or 30 days, a moving window. You don't need to worry about actually putting in specific dates. The system will calculate the dates that we're interested in. Now when we go ahead and click download, I'm going to select CSV and daily data. I'm going to give the data set a different name. So for example, my location last 7 days. Save that. Carry on, and I can now have the option to run the query, which will bring the data directly down to my hard drive and run it just once. Or I can set up the schedule and it will run at the same time every day. So let's just test by hitting run query. I go ahead, I run the query, and the server processes my locations and creates my data set for me. Okay, so the data is ready to download, and if I hit download, it's going to bring it to my local computer as an Excel CSV format that my Excel will then open automatically. So let's go ahead and do that just so we can see the data set that we're going to be working with. And here's the data. You can see that I have my locations, Berlin, Washington, Tokyo, and each of the 7 days for each of them. And this is just one file, it's a CSV file. Let's return to the application and we can now create a schedule. So this runs every day. So we're back in the view data view, and you can see that at the top, the title has changed to reflect that we're actually editing my saved query here. And if I go ahead and hit the download button, I walk through the data format options. Now, rather than hit run query, I'm now going to hit set up schedule. And I'm going to choose a time of the day that it's going to run. And I'm going to choose 5 a.m. so that the data is ready when I start work in the morning. And then I hit save schedule. And that's it. Now the data is ready. Every day at 5 a.m., the data will be run and refreshed. Now, the easiest way to get the data, if you head over to the My Datasets tab here, it will list all the data sets that I've created. And if the data is still available, I can download them. So here you can see I have the one data set, my locations last 7 days. Next to it, it's got a clock symbol. That clock symbol indicates that it's a scheduled job that's going to run at the same time every day. And then on the right-hand side, I have various options to look at the data and see the results. So I can download the data. That would be the same as downloading it just from the other tab. But I can also click and get a link, a copy a link. And this link will allow me to access the latest version of this data set after it's run every day and import it into a tool. So this is perfect for integrating the data into Excel or Google Sheets or a database. So I've copied it. So now if I head over to Excel, and I can create and import the data using the data import. So I'm going to hit get data, and then from other sources and from the web. It offers me the opportunity to provide a URL, and then that URL is the same one I just copied from the My Datasets tab. I press OK. Excel now goes to that location and brings in the data so that I can review it, and it looks good here, so I'm going to press OK. And then this now will load directly into Excel. And this is set up within Excel as an external data query so that I can refresh this whenever I want. And there's different ways you can refresh. There's a refresh button here so I can come in and manually refresh it, or I can have it refresh every day or whenever I open the tab, open the workbook. Because the weather data query always has the same URL, that means whenever Excel refreshes the data, it's going to get the latest version. So as the server refreshes the data every morning at 5 a.m., when Excel then comes in and refreshes the data, now my Excel workbook is going to have the latest data. And you can use this same approach to integrate data into Google Sheets, into a database, or even your own application as well. There's no limitation. If you just want to get the same data into Excel or into your own application, then you can use this approach, and this URL won't change, and you can just download the data. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please put them in the comments below. And do hit the subscribe button, because we'll be adding videos like this at regular intervals to help you get the most out of Visual Crossing Weather, Visual Crossing Weather Data, and the Weather Data APIs. So please check back often and check out our latest videos.